Let's fucking go.
Here we go.
Welcome. I should introduce you guys.
Sure.
So this is Claudia, my best friend. She's been on this channel a billion times.
I've just been around for a long time.
Yeah, we all know each other by now. And this is Phineas, who's never been on this channel. We've known each other for a few years now.
3 years, crazy.
Yeah, weird. And Phineas and I wrote a song called Satellite together. Wonderful song.
We wrote another song that never came out that was like a Glass Animals.
I know.
Jam.
I feel like I've heard
I wonder
it.
If it's good. I've asked you guys both to be here today because I started the series on my channel.
Yeah.
Where I have been bringing in people that either I know or don't know very well. Mm-hmm. And listening to them talk because it's so much more fun for me to hear other people talk than listen to myself talk.
And we love talking about ourselves.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's a hugely beneficial situation over here.
I know obviously a lot about you. Mm-hmm. I know you, but the majority of the time that you guys have been together, you are away from me.
It's true.
I know. So I don't know. I never know what's going on.
We're slowly integrating the wine now. We've just got one more
person.
Yeah,
we're bringing them up.
Cheers.
Come on, Phineas, get your glass.
Let's go. Do this.
My
Let's
bubble?
Go. Yes.
Looks like a bubble, like the light.
Cheers. Cheers.
All right. Can't wait to watch that moment of silence back. It's crazy because you've been dating for what? Like
a year.
A year?
Yeah, a year. It's just crazy to see like how far you guys have come. But do you have like a favorite time that you've had in your relationship, like other than obviously like right now?
Ooh.
Or when you look back and like
favorite period?
If you could like divide them in months.
Okay.
I have an answer. Do you have an answer?
If you're talking a period, I would say July, like early this summer was awesome because we had so much time together. There was really like no touring happening. But then I think about Cabo and that was our first sort of getaway together.
Cabo was awesome.
We weren't surrounded by really anyone else.
Yeah, I mooched off Claudia for like a 3-day fresh PR
your very
trip.
First influencer trip.
But it was like, I didn't know what to expect going into it, but everyone was so nice.
Yoga.
My other favorite period of our relationship thus far was the month of April, which included Coachella. Because we went to both weekends together
that was
and
very fun.
Had the most bougie Coachella experience.
Yeah. It's like such a weird thing to even think about. I mean, because it was your first Coachella playing, obviously.
First Coachella going. I've never
going?
Been.
Going?
Yeah.
Wow.
Really? Oh yeah, that was your first time, yeah.
Wow.
And meanwhile, we have gone through the mud.
Yeah. I can't even imagine what that experience would be like. Are you just getting the aroma of the wine over there?
It's
got
good
an oaky afterbirth.
It's got a it's also nutty.
Yeah.
We've had it before.
Yeah, we've had it before.
It's really
good. But there's nothing that we literally haven't done together. I've seen your poop. Like, it could have been. Yeah. Coachella!
If we're going to talk about poop and Coachella real quick. Didn't we poop in the same porta potty?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think so.
At least it was handicapped.
There was
more space.
We've been through a lot.
Yeah.
But obviously your Coachella was very different.
I think maybe like one porta potty the whole weekend.
Yeah.
You're so fortunate.
Isn't that insane? That's what I mean. I know the privileged life I walk.
Well, so what was it like being at Coachella together with someone? Because I would imagine having that be one your first Coachella on your own and playing it for the first time, like having someone there. How was your time?
Well, I've had such a great year that it feels like if I hadn't ever met Claudia, I think I'd still be like looking back at this past year and thinking about like being fortunate and like having gotten to do a lot of exciting stuff this year. But I think getting to go through it with Claudia has just made it all have this sort of like deeper importance and meaning, and I've been able to like just enjoy it and reflect on it in a better way. Because I think you basically decompress after things with a person. It's one of the things that's made my whole career fun because Billy and I have each other, and so Billy and I get to go through an experience and then come out and be like, how sick is that? And I think Claudia and I get to do that sort of to an even higher extent.
Right.
With
while
each
it's
other.
Happening too.
With both things, like with her clothing line launch and with any job she's booked or any, you know, experience she's gotten to do and feels really excited about. It's like, you know, it never feels like bragging because you get to just talk about how excited it makes you. So it's pretty awesome. The first weekend of Coachella, we had some like tech issues with like the screens were glitchy and stuff. So it was kind of an intense experience, and I was really grateful to have Claudia there with me.
Just like genuinely on your side.
Totally. Yeah. And just was so kind to me through that whole experience. It was great.
Yeah. Yeah. No, I remember after that, because I noticed like the screen glitch and everything, but I thought you guys did such a good job. So I just remember like running backstage, just like wanting to congratulate them. And they're both just like, it was like just from 100 to zero.
Were there any other like crazy or weird moments?
Of Coachella?
Coachella?
Right after that, time-wise.
Oh like yeah, this is later. Right in the same chunk.
So right after you're at Coachella, you go to Australia.
Yes. The next day. Yes. So Coachella is like the weekend of Easter. Mm-hmm. On Easter Sunday, my family flies to Australia. And Australia is like one of my favorite countries in the world. It's
wonderful
such
people.
A great part of the world. Yeah. And I go like, Claudia, like I know this isn't like the busiest season for like auditions and stuff. Mm-hmm. Do you want to, I'll fly you out if you want to come to Australia for like a full week, because it's a far flight.
Sure.
She agrees, which is super fun. I go, here's what we'll do. I'll look at the schedule. Okay, this week we have like 2 or 3 days off. One of those days off, we're on an island.
How fun.
We're on this like—
How fun.
Set, how fun.
Like, this like, we're taking like a helicopter to the island. We're
amazing.
Gonna, we're
normal,
ride,
normal things.
We're gonna
good
ride
to
horses on the beach. I was like, this is insane,
course,
right?
Yeah.
So I'm like, payback for Cabo. Like, I get to do this for you.
Oh, I see. Oh, that's cute.
Yes.
So she lands. She's like, understandably, like worn out. We have this wonderful day. We're staying in a really nice hotel in this area of Australia called Townsville.
Yeah.
She comes to a show that night. She's all jet lagged. I'm still kind of jet lagged. We go to bed at like 9 p.m. It's very civilized.
Grandparents.
Yeah.
So. Well, this was the day.
Taking
a chopper. Horseback riding.
Taking a chopper,
to the island.
Island.
The island's
going
called
on a
Magnetic
boat.
Island.
Magnetic Island.
I remember hearing. Yep.
Of course.
Yeah, get on a boat. We've got this scheduled horse ride into the sunset waters.
Mm-hmm.
Where do we begin?
So we wake up, we're in like, I don't even know, sometimes rooms get divvied up weird. It felt like we were in like the penthouse of the whole hotel. So we're in this really high, beautiful hotel
nice
on the
room.
Water.
They said Claudia and Phineas are coming.
They are clearly.
Yes.
We're giving them up.
Let's clear our schedules.
We like woke up and we were on jet lag, so we woke up at like 6 in the morning, opened all the windows, like breathed in the sea
air
with the breeze in our faces.
This
and
comes
then,
up later.
And then they're like, okay, so come downstairs, we're gonna do the helicopter over the island. We're like, sick. That's super fun. We go with my sister and my parents on the helicopter. We get to the island. We get on a boat on the island,
super fun.
Sail around for a while.
Wow. Cute.
Super fun, kind of exhausting. And we on the boat we rode like a motorboat the big boat.
We did it in Greece a bunch.
Oh yeah, you take the little boat.
The boat
to the big
from
boat.
The boat.
The little what are they called? Not a doobie. That is literally it. It was like a little.
Oh.
We take that to the shore of the island and we're like snorkeling. A dinghy.
Good job.
Take that
anyways,
in.
Yeah.
We're like, and it's all super idyllic at this point, and we're like in wetsuits because
this jellyfish.
Jellyfish that like kill you. Like they're like, hey, they're like, wear this wetsuit because there's sea jellies. And the sea jellies are terribly poisonous, and you're like, okay, and they're like, die, you'll totally die. So, this continues. So we go into the island, and Claudia and I fancy ourselves like rather athletic and fit.
Yeah.
And so everybody's taking the dinghy back to the boat way out in the harbor.
Oh, my God, I forgot about this.
And you say what? You'll swim?
We'll swim.
Oh, great.
Halfway from the shore to the boat, you're like, I think I might have to drown. Like,
how many meters do you think that was?
30 feet. Like,
no length
of time. And we were both just like, whoa, like
way farther than 30 feet.
It felt really far. And like, definitely didn't have snorkels or goggles.
Sure.
So we were just like swimming.
Just like SPF and salt. Just
and we got on the boat.
Open your face.
We get on the boat. And at this point, because of like our jet lag, we've been up for like 12 hours already. And we get back on the boat. And
we're exhausted.
Like pouring seawater out of our ears.
Yeah.
And the sun's setting and we're like, wow, that was a fun day. And someone's like, you ready to ride horses through the jungle for 2.5 hours? And we're like,
sure.
Oh yeah. We drive our car like around.
Like
to this
horse stable
like ranch.
In the
middle of the
island.
Yeah. And we get there and it's like pretty like ranchy. Billy loves riding horses.
What do you mean by ranchy?
Like a farm or a ranch. Like dirt and like picket fences.
Your average
and
ranch.
Yeah.
Hoses.
Yeah.
Okay.
Cowboy hats.
It's pretty ranchy.
Yeah.
If you've seen Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, the Manson Ranch would be the right description.
Okay. That's good.
And we get put on our horses everyone that works there is like a Swedish exchange student, which just adds to the color.
That's
of
like
the story.
Working there temporarily.
You will get on the horse now, yes? So you get on horses and you're riding, and like for 10 minutes, you're like, this is pretty. And yeah. It's kind of this.
Now we're going through a forest. Now, I personally had, I was on, Sprinkles? I think mine was called Sprinkles.
Who cares?
Let me just go through my personal experience with my horse before we get into the peak of this story.
Okay.
When the workers asked, you know, like, what horse I got, and I was like, I have Sprinkles, and they all go, yes, that one.
Ah, yes, the Sprinkles horse.
doesn't really get along with the rest of the horses. So
super
I
awesome.
So I am particularly placed in line because apparently... In the back,
second to back.
And you know, my horse can't be around like three other horses because they have beef. Oh. So we had to put a neutral horse in front of mine.
That's right.
Okay. Also, mine's a snacker, so
stops to feed. Yeah,
every 5 seconds. Mm. And so the whole ride, I'm like, you know, come on, because Sprinkles is stopping and snacking.
They're very strong.
And then Sprinkles decided to skip a few horses and try to cut to the front of the line. So I'm over here like, whoa, you know what I mean? But I slowed her down, it was fine. Anyways, let's just get into like the thick of it.
So the main deal is like, you wanna like try to be an optimist in these situations and you feel very privileged and you're like, it's a thing that you, like we'd already been kind of bragging about it for like a couple weeks. Like, yeah, we get to go ride horses in Australia.
We were excited, we were stoked.
So Claudia's on Sprinkles, I'm on my horse, Chris Clemens, and we're riding our horses through the jungle and it's like too long.
Yeah.
And the ride was billed as sunset ride on the beach.
Okay.
And we're going through the jungle.
And now it's dusk.
For like an hour.
Sure.
When we get out to the shore.
Yeah.
And Claudia and I, first of all, like haven't, like when you're on a horse, you can't like talk to someone else because you're a single file.
Yeah.
So it's not like we've been talking for an hour.
Yeah, it's a solo.
So we get off the horses, both our vaginas are sore. And we get off the horses and we're both like, immediately like a little admitting that we didn't have a good time. Like we're both just like
yeah, we're lackluster. Really,
yeah, we're like, okay, I think we're tapping,
and like,
we want to
okay,
tap
we'll
out.
Take the saddles off the horses now and you ride in the surf? And we're like, fuck, bareback? Like, we're gonna ride in water bareback?
Yeah.
So we take the saddles off.
I'm like, on my horse, you want me to go bareback on Sprinkles?
Yeah, we ride down into the surf.
Yeah.
And it's still single file and it's, you're like trying to like just use your like Kegels to balance on the horse.
And you're like holding on, you're gripping onto its mane.
You feel bad,
yeah.
you feel bad. For the horse
or
anything. And you walk down the water pretty deep, like up to like your waist. So
yeah,
your legs
you're
are like
waist
in the water.
Deep in
is
the water.
Horse just completely underwater?
Horses,
yes.
Yeah,
yes.
The horses are like, their neck is out.
Yeah.
And they're like, they enjoy it, right?
Yeah.
And meanwhile, like the horses the entire hour.
Ask them.
The entire, I know, seriously. What pole did they answer on? We get down in the water and the whole hour prior to the water, they've just been like blithely shitting on the path, which is like the like for sure. And so we're in the water now and their shit floats. And Claudia and I are, Claudia and I are downstream.
So
all of the horses in front of our horses are shitting and all of the shit is floating around our kneecaps.
I think the first moment it hit us was actually Sprinkles had to shit.
Oh,
because
so
the pole was snacking. So I think it hit you first. All of a sudden, I'm riding. I'm like, ooh, the water's cool. It's nice because it's 100 degrees out.
It was so hot.
We're sweating.
Holy crap.
And I just hear Phineas right behind me go, oh, oh no, oh God, oh fuck.
I want to go out on the record and say, like, I'm not angry at these horses. I'm angry at the whole situation. Like, what it has taught me is, like, every time since then that I've seen anybody bareback in the water, I'm like, shit is knocking in their kneecaps.
Yeah.
And they got this photo and they're like, yesterday it was a movie. And I'm like, yeah,
a horror movie.
A movie with horse shit and piss on your ankle. Now you're wet on a horse for an hour in the jungle it's nighttime and there's just like so much life in the forest.
So I have to go poop.
I forgot about this part of the story, but I'm so glad you remembered.
There's like this sort of outhouse as the bathroom. I go up to the toilet, I open the lid, I immediately spot shit in the toilet. And I, you know, I take a little double take,
like,
then I realize, oh my God, no, the shit moved.
Oh, oh, oh no.
It was a toad.
Really big toe.
That's cute.
A large toe.
I thought you were gonna say it was like a tarantula or something.
And then one of the girls who's working at the ranch pulls the toad out with her hand, throws it over.
Out the window.
Like it's nothing. No, it was like out the door, yeah. I was like, amazing, awesome, thank you so much for saving the day. And I'm now shitting. And I don't know when I realized this, but there were three other toads just under the toilet seat.
It's also one of those experiences where you're a little bit like, so there's like a huge toad in the toilet and the people that work there are like, Oh, yeah. That happens a lot of the time.
Yeah.
And you feel like you're the weird one.
Yeah.
They're like, and?
That was sort of our next animal experience. And then we get back on the sort of ferry that gets us back to Townsville, right?
A journey.
And we are just so happy to be back home.
I'm sure.
You know, if we jump back to the beginning of this story.
When we open the windows for the cool breeze.
When Phineas opened the windows and sliding doors
to let
in some open air.
He's not we.
And what did we come home to?
An apartment full of life.
Every single insect?
Yeah.
I think there is under the sun.
On the bed, on the
walls.
On
the pillows, on the walls, on the ceiling,
on
all the lamps, on the sink.
Frog in the sink.
There was a frog in the sink, so we weren't done with those.
Claudia was making this noise that was like, as she checked different surfaces of the apartment.
Didn't you get food poisoning the next morning?
Next morning, yeah.
Yeah, wow. From the buffet.
Yeah.
Truly a trip in paradise.
You're like, how much can we complain about this experience?
I know, it honestly, I think through all of it, we were dying laughing. Like, I don't look back on this.
I thought the bugs was hilarious.
Yeah, you thought
it was hilarious. The toll was hilarious.
That was definitely the most frustrating to me because I knew that we had to go to sleep.
Yeah.
Of course.
And they were, like,
you know
what's
crazy is that we didn't get bitten by anything.
I know.
I didn't wake up with any bug bites.
They were like flying bugs, crawling bugs.
Oh
they were
God.
Everywhere.
And listen, like, I don't think the point is about complaining about what you've been through.
No.
Like, love this story because, you know, like everyone sees y'all went to Australia.
I know.
Yeah. Sees you went to Australia.
Cute.
No one knows. Like,
no one
really
knows
what the fuck. Because that's what happens on every family vacation.
100%.
Mm-hmm. That's what happens when you're with any. It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
That's why I love these stories. Because they're just so, like, I mean, everyone has been through them in their own way.
100%.
It's hilarious.
Oh my God, it was so funny.
Well, I'm so sorry that you went through that, but I'm also so happy that you
did.
It was truly
amazing. It taught us a lot of patience.
Yeah.
I think a lot of patience, camaraderie.
There's a lot of empathy.
There's a lot of empathy.
A lot of laughter.
Yeah.
Well, that is so fun. Thank you so much for sharing.
Thanks for having us on your show.
That was an amazing story. I mean, both of you have a lot going on right now. Mm-hmm. I want to tell them about it. Claudia just released a freaking clothing line with Nordstrom, which is amazing. I wear the underwear on the daily.
Me too.
Phineas as well, you have a new EP coming out.
It's true.
You're also going on tour.
It's true.
You have everything going on.
I have everything going on,
except a clothing line.
Except a clothing line.
Which Claudia fills in the gap.
There you go.
That is truly, I mean, just having known you for so long, seeing you two together, just truly you complement each other's lives so
well.
And I love to see it as friends of you both.
Oh my gosh.
Well, Rebecca's known both of us longer than we've known each other.
I know.
Was there the night I met Claudia. Let me crash the party and come on.
I've never even told you this. I've told you this. But the first time we ever worked together, I remember a thought so clearly being like, he would be obsessed with Claudia.
I am.
And here you are.
Right.
There's videos
that fans have been tweeting us of like you talking about me to Claudia, like whatever, 2 years ago.
You were showing me one of
like,
those
I worked,
songs.
You're like, you know the artist Billie
Eilish?
Oh
my series. Yeah,
I worked with her brother.
Yeah.
And Claudia's just like, oh, cool. Like, it's just the cutest little like unaware. Like, that's cool.
No, thank you guys.
No, you absolutely
so much. Please pay attention to both of them. They're just, I mean, you are already, let's be real, but they're both just lovely people. Hopefully this showed you a little bit more about your lives. Just because you get to go to Coachella or you get to go to Australia or whatever, like you are still a fucking human and shit happens. Not
literally.
Everything is cool, but still you're both so lucky. You know that very well
and
they know that you know that. So this was just fantastic.
This is good.
Couldn't do it better.
Awesome.
I sat back and listened the entire time.
Thanks
I'll
for watching.
Thanks for going. Bye.
Say bye.
You guys, that was just magical.
Yeah? Okay.
Magical.